like where you're located now. And Janet's told me how great going to the meetings and you know, just, of course, there's no meetings right now. But,
a little different world this year.
Yeah, being a part of a group like Anna's. Thank you, Anna.
Absolutely.
Okay, and Janet, tell everybody else also what, you know, a little bit about yourself. Did you talk about your personal life at all, or?
No, we were just saying hi as we kind of came in and kind of waiting for you to get in here too as well and see how we wanted to maintain this. But yeah, I have actually, as I said, I've been in Mary Kay for about 20 years, it's hard to believe, but it was always alongside of my corporate career. So my background is in accounting payroll. I was in oil and gas and banking for over 20 years as well. So this was always alongside. I moved out down from Pennsylvania to North Carolina and decided I was going to do full-time Mary Kay. The Lord let me do that for a year and decided that I needed to do something slightly different where I was going to blend my corporate background along with my Mary Kay training and be able to offer accounting, basically an accounting lifeline to small business owners. Because too many of them just didn't understand what was going on. The numbers confused them. So I launched Excel With Me Training and Consulting 2 years ago. So it blends that corporate, my Mary Kay business, and allows me a unique position because of being a small business owner also for 20 years. So I get to blend both of them together. So that's where it was at. And then last year, I was blessed enough to be able to launch my book, Money Doesn't Spend Itself. So where did it go? And it's all about making sure those numbers are in place. So Hammy, this is Hammy. He's helping people turn Hamiltons into Benjamins. And that's his job this year. So we have been focusing on cash flow and getting systems in place for all small business owners. So that and trying to take that confusion out of it. So that's why we're here tonight, as I get a chance to kind of talk about what I love to talk about is getting those systems in place. So I want to share a little bit with you guys on like the 60-40 split, because sometimes that gets confusing. And I know for team members, it was really confusing. So I had this nice little spreadsheet. It was pretty crazy, but it worked really, really well. So I kind of scaled it back a little bit and want to share that with you guys tonight and kind of give you a feel.
And I wondered if you would be able to record this.
Because it's recording.
Super. Okay.
So we'll and then I'll figure out how to get it to you.
All right. Yeah, we'll figure that. You can probably email me a link or something.
Yeah, I'll pop it up to YouTube. That'd I have a YouTube awesome. Channel. And then I can send you the link. And then we can figure out how to get it there or whatever we need to do, because I put it to my computer.
So I hope everybody's ready to take notes. And don't forget, you can ask questions when we're done. Mm-hmm. And so I'm going to go ahead and turn this over to Janet.
Very cool. I'm going to go ahead and share my screen because I kind of wanted to get a little bit of a feel, and then we're going to jump into an opportunity. So I am going to go ahead and pop this over. And as I said, as we were kind of going through a lot of this, it's kind of interesting. And I have found like money doesn't spend itself. So of course, where did it go? That has been my tagline for quite a while. And are we good to go? You seeing the right one and not my notes? Awesome. All right. So often I get this question, and that's usually the look I get too, because they have absolutely no idea where in the world money's going. And I bet, I'm going to guess with the consultants too, especially with your team members, a lot of times they see these sales coming in, it's wonderful, but all of a sudden at the end of the day, it's been a little bit of a challenge. And I think money management tends to be a bit of a challenge. So what I'm hoping to do tonight is to really kind of take this right back to basics. Get it back to basics and start looking and see if we can make this simple. And that's my goal. I didn't say easy, I said simple. Because when we don't manage our money very well, too often what ends up happening, of course, is you spend more than you make. You also tend to max out credit cards, or team members tend to max out credit cards, or yourself tends to max out credit cards. That's not a good thing. A lot of times they forget to pay themselves. I'm finding this across the boards with too many business owners, whether it's Mary Kay business or any other business, too often that money's not there. And we want to put a priority on that. And, you know, can be a little stressed out when bills are coming. So these are kind of the things that I'm seeing that correlate to not only Mary Kay, but to small business, but very much to my Mary Kay sisters as well. Because how do you know you're profitable? Tax time is always a challenge. All of a sudden, as a small business owner, Mary Kay consultants, we have to do a Schedule C now. But if you don't track that Schedule C, where are you going? And that's part of the challenge that comes into here. So I'm going to suggest some things there. And of course, we want to make sure we keep the money into our pockets. I have also found when I was talking to folks that confused mind. You kind of look at that picture, and what does a confused mind do? Any ideas on that one? What do you think? You can always pop into the chat or kind of open up. I like to have discussion, but a confused mind, Anna knows this one because we talk about this one a lot. What's a confused mind do?
Does nothing.
It does nothing. And that's exactly what we want to prevent. We want to be doing something. We want to be able to say, where did my money go? If it's not in my account, where is it? Because this is not the look we want to do when we're coming through. So where do we start? And in Mary Kay, she goes back to principles. I have gotten so many foundational principles from my Mary Kay training that has led me in corporate. It has led me also in my small business and across the board. And I've been able to share with a lot of my team members over the years and Mary Kay sisters as well. And it goes back to that 60-40 split. And so that's what I'm really going to focus on today. And what's the foundation for that? The bottom line is we got to track everything. And that a lot of times causes this look because you're just not sure what to do. And when that happens, all of a sudden it's like, okay, where are we going to go? What direction are we going to go? You mean I have to track everything? That's just too much. We're going to take a step back and we're going to say, what can we do? Well, the crazy part about it is there's so many choices out there. You can go as crazy as pen and paper. You can go to a spreadsheet. You can even jump into a software. I do specialize in training QuickBooks on my other business here, so that's one of there. But of course, Main Street Boulevard is the one that's dedicated for Mary Kay. I've used Main Street for 20 plus years as well. It was a beauty advisor when I started with it, and it is a way to track it. And the bottom line is this, what's the best system? It's always one answer, and this is always my answer to everyone. When I get asked this question, and I get it asked quite a bit, it's simply the one that you're going to use. And that's what I want to encourage you. We're going to find one and we're going to actually focus on looking at the options that are proactive, not reactive. And that's the direction that we're going. So as we're looking at how do we be proactive? One of those ways to be proactive is when you think about your checking account, we want to go ahead and we're going to take our checking account. And we're going to think of it this way. Everything comes into a checking account, but yet we're going to put, and I call him my little golden piggy. Now, when I'm working with small business owners, especially I encourage two checking accounts. We're not at that level right now, but I want you to think about it and kind of still think with two different ways. There's going to be a section of our money that's off limits. And what do I mean by that? It means when the sales come in, we're going to be proactive and we're going to tell our money where it's going. And this is very commonly known as the envelope system. Most of you may have heard that, especially from Dave Ramsey. He's known for the envelope system. And that's exactly what we're talking about here. And that's all the 60-40 split actually is. It's actually taking a look and we're basically going to give ourselves inventory, preferred customer, as well as section two, I abbreviated, so it would fit into there. And that's our 60%. And that leaves us then, we only get 100% to work with. So we have our 100% that's there, we have 40% that's left over. And here's what ends up happening too often is we forget that we, and Mary Kay taught us, we need to be proactive in our approach. And that's exactly what we're doing here. We're going to take out and find a way to very simply bring our inventory, our PCP and our section two items. And we're going to have that sitting in what I'm calling my little golden piggy as we were kind of talking a little bit about that. And the other 40% is our operating expenses and our pay. And that's what we're looking at. And that's what Mary Kay has taught us to do is we have that 60-40 split. That's where it's coming from. So let's take a look at that. So in essence, all that's happening is we're pulling out that information. And I'm going to kind of share a little bit about the taxes too, because the taxes are things that we pay up front. So as we place our orders in there, we've already paid the taxes on that. So as we're collecting the sales tax on our sales receipts, we want to make sure that's moved over right along with the inventory, the preferred customer premiums, and the section two item. And we're going to talk a little bit about that as well. And what's left? What's left in the pink piggy? It's simply our operating expenses. But as we're thinking about that, that's also our pay. And I think that's where sometimes we get a little tripped up as we're looking at things. We're not backing off. We're seeing that $100 that's coming in, but we're not thinking about it that I have $40 to work with for my operating expenses. And that's where is if we can start to be more proactive in our approach, it makes it much simpler. Because that 40%, what we're working with, of course, is our pay. But it also includes all of those supplies, whether that's advertising and marketing, whether that's our software. I encourage saving up for seminars. Now, we're not traveling right now. Everything's virtual. So that price has come down quite a bit. But as we were traveling and when I was doing my spreadsheets, I would allocate out every single sales at the end of the month. I did mine monthly. You can do it weekly as well. And I'm going to encourage folks to do it that way. I'm going to walk you through a spreadsheet and we'll give you a copy of it and see how things go. But also with our loans, as we start inventory, we invest in our business. This is an investment for us where we can actually deliver on the spot. And that's one of the privileges that Mary Kay offers us, is we are able to go ahead and invest in inventory. That's fine and dandy, but I encourage, it's okay to get started with there. But what I want to make sure is when you have those loans, that they're built into these operating expenses and you have a plan to pay it back. And I can honestly say in 20 years, I've never been in debt for Mary Kay. I have been able to be proactive in my approach. Did I go ahead and invest in my business? Of course I did. But I had a very solid plan to have that paid off in a very short time frame because I focused on making sure I was a proactive approach. And that works. And that's what we're going to encourage. All right. As we're continuing through there. So hopefully, I mean, that makes a lot of sense as we were going through. And it's not too confusing. But let's take a second. And let's say we had a $500 sale. That's what we have. Whether a week, month. Let's say, let's go for a week. We had a great week this week. And we had $500 in sales and $30 in taxes. As we're thinking about that, here's how the system works. We start out with 50%. And what does 50% go back into? It goes back into our inventory. Because of course, we get a 50% discount. So if we're an active consultant, we actually get a 50% discount. So as I'm doing that, but I'm going to pay my taxes on the full retail of that, which is how the tax number just ends up squaring up and it actually zeroes itself out by taking this approach. That leaves us 10% in that 60%. Remember, we're talking about a 60-40 split. So that leaves us 10% for the preferred customer premium as well as Section 2 items. And what's encouraged and what I have been taught over the years that I've been doing it is pretty much that PCP and the Section 2, it's about 5% on each one. So that's a good goal to get started with. But you shouldn't be spending more than like about 10% of what you're bringing in on those lovely Section 2 items, which most of us can get really going crazy on because they're fun. And it's real easy to do that by keeping that in mind, though, making it 10% and being aware of exactly how much you have available to you makes a huge difference. And guess what? Those two numbers there, or three numbers, however you want to take a look at it, total are 60%. And what we're doing is the taxes. The taxes is just what I consider like a sweep account. And all I mean is when you have $530 that you collected, the $30 in tax automatically goes into the account to replace your inventory because that's just your taxes. The 50%, there's your inventory. And that leaves then 10% for the PCP and the Section 2. So what about the other 40%? If you're looking at that, that leaves us say 30% in pay. And 10% in operating expenses. These are percentages. These are guidelines. These are goals. Does that mean it's going to be exactly on the pay and the operating expenses? Possibly not. If you are actually investing back in your business and you have a loan to pay, that has to be accounted for that. So you may have a little less of a pay initially, but your business is paying your loan. Your business will turn to be profitable if you get these practices and habits into place. And that's all this is. And that's what Mary Kay teaches us, is that we need to get good habits when it comes to money management so that our business is successful. And long term, that's the only way of being able to be successful, is we've got to take control of it. But of course, we don't want to make it too crazy either. So taking about percentages, that sometimes glosses folks over. So let's take it back to just simple numbers. We had $500 in sales. We had $30 in our taxes. That $30 jumps right back in there. If I look at my inventory, that's just 50%. So that's $300. So 530 off the top, that or 330 goes into what we're talking about. So the yellow there, that's going to go back to replace our inventory. It's going to cover our PCP and it's going to cover our section two. So that leaves us then with 150 for our pay if we can stick to the 30%. And that gives me $50 of my operating expenses. So now I know that I have what I can work with. I know exactly the direction I'm going in, and I can make better decisions. And that's what all this is about. And if you're thinking about it, I always call him my little golden piggy. You're allocating that out in an envelope system. You're putting it off to the side, and you're not spending it unless it's for inventory, PCP, and section two, because that's your 60%. And in order to have it on your shelf, you need to be able to replace it. And so that's how that's working. And of course, the rest is your operating expense. And the ultimate goal is, how do you break out that 40%? Which stack are you putting it in? And that's something that as the business owner, you've got to figure out. But that's the cool thing. You own your own business as a Mary Kay consultant. This is your business. And we can actually do that. So whether your operating expenses, first and foremost, though, and the biggest jar needs to be your pay. You need to be making sure that your business is paying you. Now, is that going to fluctuate? Of course it is. That's just part of owning your own business. But the nice thing is, if you're taking a proactive approach and you're using this percentage split that Mary Kay has taught us, she was one, very smart business lady. Let's learn, that's what I'm encouraging. Take advantage of what she's taught us. I have used this method. Sometimes my percentages have not always been 30% to my paycheck. Okay, but we can work towards it and we can move towards that. And that's what makes the difference. So you just got to figure out how you got to split that up. Is it for seminar? Is it for something else? Is it to make sure you have a website? There's all kinds of things out there. But the trick is to be proactive. And the only way you can be proactive is to be thinking about this up front. Always got to take a little bit of time to work on your business. And I know sometimes it's hard to do that. And what I encourage my clients and those that I work with, even with my teammates as well, whether it's Friday afternoon, whether it's Sunday morning, afternoon, whatever it ends up being, Sunday morning, whatever time, church, I mean, work it around as you're going. Schedule a time with yourself and figure out how to break this out. We all are supposed to be putting in weekly accomplishment sheets. Okay, that's a perfect time to be able to use this information and figure out what's going on. The idea is to do it little by little so that you can have solid information come the end of the month to know what happened, so you can project where to go forward. You can't hit your goals. You can't hit that dartboard if you don't know where you're going. And I often use the example from the dartboard. You're throwing your goals towards your financial goals and you're sending those darts forward. The only problem is if you're not tracking that information and you're not taking a proactive approach, the dartboard might be behind you. And you can be throwing those darts all day long and you're never going to hit the bullseye. We want you to hit the bullseye each and every time, because I don't want this to be on the look on your face. So how can I help you to do that? I'm going to suggest, and I'm going to offer an opportunity to go ahead and look. Now it's in Google Sheets, so I'm going to grab that link here in just a second. And as soon as I move us out of the way and get that going through, because my ultimate goal is I want you to make sure that you have a very solid understanding. Yeah, it won't let me share that. We'll look at that. I'll have to grab it here in a second. I will give that to you in just a second and kind of going from there. So allow me to bounce out of here and stop the share. And I'm going to give you a link to pull that in. And you guys can follow along with me. And so if you guys are familiar with the chat, I'm going to go pop this into the chat here and stop this share. And the chat is down at the bottom. It looks like the little, most people are probably familiar. Does anybody not know where the chat is? I guess that's probably a better question. If you don't know, let me know. This is a Google Sheet. Basically, it's an Excel spreadsheet. And I'm going to encourage us to work it together. And here's where I'm going to suggest to make this super, super easy. Not easy. That's a bad choice of words. Because you know what? Money management's not easy. It's not easy, but it is simple. And that's what we're going to take a look at. So here we go. I'm going to pull it up in Excel because I'm an Excel nut. Google Sheets, I fight Google. I anger the Google gods on a regular basis. but that's okay. But Google is a free opportunity. It's a spreadsheet. And a spreadsheet is just taking the math out of the numbers. And I'll pick on Anna because she doesn't mind if I pick on her usually. She was pen and paper when I met her. I have converted her as we are looking. Pen and paper works because remember, the best system for you is the one you're going to use. And if that's what it is, so be it. I can't handle pen and paper, so we're going to go to a spreadsheet level. And I'm going to encourage you. Hopefully I've given everybody a chance to go ahead and grab this. I'm going to go back to sharing my screen and I'm going to pull up the Excel version of it as we're going here. And we should, well, hello. Well, that's interesting. Anna, did it come up? We're good? We're good? Awesome. Awesome. So here is the spreadsheet. And basically, here's what we're doing. This is a month. So what I did is I scaled back. I actually had multiple tabs and linked them all together. That's a little bit more complicated than I wanted to get into in a very quick presentation as far as just to kind of get you started. But you are welcome to grab and download this. You simply need to go into the Google and do a save as copy, or save as, I think it is, or save copy, I think, in Google. As I said, I talk Excel language. Save a copy down, and then you can use this each and every month. But it's taking a look at, if you put in the pink areas, so basically you start up here, what month are we working on? We're doing our weekly accomplishment sheets. And now InTouch has made life so much easier. All of that information is pretty much there. You know how much your sales are because you're entering that information in and you're gathering those sales receipts. So if you do something like this in this spreadsheet, let's say week one was $500, because that was the example I used with the piggies as we were talking. You'll notice I already have the formulas built in. So if you go ahead and you open that file up, let's go ahead and put $500 in and kind of let me walk you through kind of what's happening, because it may not be easy, but it can be simple. And this is what I'm going to encourage folks. So what I did here is we know that 60% has to be our inventory slash PCP plus, you know, like this section here. Remember, it was made up of three different categories. 50% here, 5% to section two, and 5% to PCP. If I add all of those together, guess what they equal? The 60%. So here's what I have to work with. I had $500 in week one. If I take a look at it, remember, we take the sales tax off. Now, I use 6% in this example. It's just a formula. And formulas in Excel are up here in the top piece. And you can see that I put 6%. Pennsylvania is 6%. And we're 6.75 here in North Carolina. But we are 6% up in Pennsylvania. So I use that number here. The formulas automatically, remember, all the spreadsheet does is take the math out of it. It saves us from getting on the calculator and retyping and retyping and retyping. So if I do the thought process and that proactive approach that Mary Kay has taught us, that means that I've got $250 back for my inventory, and I got 25 in each of my section two and PCP. I went ahead and I added in and said, okay, operating expense 10, I took my pay down to 25%. Because I'm a firm believer in getting some training, because I want to go to seminar. I want to go to career conference. I want to be able to do that. And I want my business to pay for that. So I'm going to take a proactive approach on that. So it is sitting there and I'm able to go. So I know what I'm up against. Now I know that I've got this number sitting here. Well, that was 1 week. This is set for a month. So maybe the next week I had $100. Maybe the next week I had $200. Maybe this week I didn't have such a great week and I only had $50. It's part of the business. But the nice thing here is you can see I've had $850 in sales. This matches up to your weekly accomplishments. As I said, we're just taking that last line item off of there, because InTouch is recording all this for you. You can actually do inventory now through InTouch. When we, 20 years ago, we didn't have that option. So you can actually do that as well. So it limits not having to have maybe some of the actual inventory and things. It also depends on what part of your business that you're in as well and what you're tracking. QuickBooks is a great option for different things, but it may not be the right solution for you at this time, or maybe it will be later. It took a while as Anna was growing. We actually moved her from a spreadsheet up to, you know, self-employed QuickBooks. There's different variations, all kinds of different things. Arm yourself with information and don't jump into a specific software. Start here. Start with something that's going to work. Start with pen and paper if that's what it takes. We can take a look here. We know that we have sales tax. So you can see the numbers and the math was taken care of. But that's only half of the equation. That's our money coming in. What about money going out? We got to deal with that. So what I did here is you'll notice that there's two tabs. there's a tab called expenses. So one thing we can do is we can track all those lovely receipts that we get. So at the end of the week, all you need to do is kind of come in here. I have this dated. It's 1 to 31. Did I spend anything on inventory? Okay, it's the 8th of the month. I actually went ahead and I just had $200. So of that, how much was tax? I didn't do that math. Okay, 6%. What is that? What? Yeah, I can't do math today, but that's okay. Section 2, what do we do? How much? Well, if we have, what are we putting back? I don't know. I'm not sure. Wait a minute. I do know what I have to work with. Come right back over here to your summary. You know exactly where you're at any time, any given time. And you know that you had $400 worth to work with inventory. So before you go in and do that inventory, make sure you know how much you have to work with. Make sure you know how much you have for section 2. And of course your PCP, you know where that's at as well. So you know ahead of time. So instead of guessing and say, oh, I'll come up with it, and instead of picking up your phone and saying, oh, my bank balance says I have this amount, you're taking a proactive approach and you know exactly that you got 400 to work with. So, okay, I can do my 200 works, but no, that's not my, now I want to make sure I have my 225 in. I want my minimum order because you also want it, you're paying shipping and handling on all this as well. So try to be smart if you can, can't always, but. And of course, we have the preferred customer now that we have the delivery system. I know I take advantage of that a lot, especially this past year. And I'm sure folks do as well. But we'll look at this as doing the big order. You can account for this for the little orders, just as simple. And you put everything in. So maybe I spent $10 there. Maybe down here, my PCP was due because that was just due here. And maybe I spent, well, probably not $335. How much did I have for my pay? Oh, shoot, I don't remember. Go back to your summary. I know that I've got $200 that I'm working with. Well, maybe I needed to take $100 out here on the 10th. Maybe I'm going to pay myself some more over here. I had 212, so I have another 100 here. Just go down to the whatever date it is and put your numbers in. Take your receipts, put them through. $20 because we're going to go to career conference. $20 virtual. So there we go. This is going to add up. Spreadsheet's just taking the math out of it. So I know that in the month of April, this is what I spent. It's just general, but the cool thing is it then flows back over to the other side. And now I can see exactly where I'm at. I know exactly as time is going throughout the month, as I'm spending, what I'm up against. I'm taking a proactive approach and going back to Mary Kay's 60-40 split, so that I can make better business decisions and set myself up for success, set myself up for growth. Because as you start adding team members, you can add on a few extra columns. Maybe as you start adding on and you get further along, maybe it's time to start looking at a software to kind of help take care of some of this. It's one step at a time and it can be done and it can be simple. And this is just a way to kind of take a look at that. So I can look and I can see that the month of April, I actually had profit of $371. So I did good this month. And that's the whole thing is when you're in business for yourself, there's ups, there's downs, there's ups, there's downs. And this is one way to start looking at this. And you can add some additional formulas and say, okay, where was I starting? So you can run a running balance if you need to. There's different tweaks that can be done. And that's one thing that I did is I had it rolling. I had a summary sheet in the front and then I had one tab for every single month. There's different ways to kind of make it simplistic to be able to know exactly what you're up against so that you can make informed decisions and not be reactive. Because when we're reactive, I don't know about you, but I make some silly decisions when I'm reactive. Don't recommend it. I've gotten, you know, hit the hard way, whether it's just, we just don't make good decisions when we have to react. But if you're prepared and working forward, it does make a huge difference. So what I wanted to do is I wanted to kind of give you a fair, and then I wanted to open the floor up. I love communication. I love an opportunity to kind of say, what questions do you have? What can we do differently? What questions do you have? Debbie, you had said something about inventory. I'm not sure exactly what you were thinking on that one. I would know I was touching here. Was there another question around that? So I open it up for you. I'm going to go ahead and stop the share for right now. I can pop up the Excel spreadsheet as we're going. But go ahead and unmute. I do appreciate you guys muting as we were talking here, but go ahead and unmute and I'd love to have some conversation.
Okay, my one question is that sheet you just showed us, is that like a software program you use?
Nope, no, that is simply, I did it in Excel. And when okay. The link, I uploaded it to Google Sheets. If you have a Gmail account, if you don't have one, create one. And it is part of what they consider the G Suite, which is simply a Google Sheet.
Okay.
And you have a Gmail, which I know you do, Debbie, if mm-hmm. you go to the 9 little box, there's little dots up there.
Mm-hmm.
Next to it, you just click on that. And one of them is the Drive there, or Google Sheets, I'm sorry, is right there. It's called Google Sheets.
Okay.
And it's the free version of Microsoft Excel.
I have not used that or looked at it. Thank you for that.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, grab that. It's a link up in there. You know, it's right on my Google Drive.
So you simply created it from that then.
Mm-hmm. That's where I started.
Now, that link that you gave us in the mm-hmm. chat, is that's your Google mm-hmm. Sheet?
That's the Google Sheet, yep.
And you, how do I get that off of the chat and save that?
Okay, what you'll do is, under the chat, if you go ahead, you can click on it. It should automatically open up Google for you. And mm-hmm. the other thing that you can do is if you highlight across it and highlight it,
mm-hmm.
you can hit Control and the letter C on your keyboard. That's a copy. And you can paste it anywhere you want. So often encourage folks to open up whatever you're using, whether it's Word or whether it's just Notepad or whatever you're using, and just drop that link there so that at any given time you can get to it.
Yeah, thank you.
Of course, absolutely. And as I said, you can tweak it and kind of go. It just make that copy and work for each month. And then you'll know at the end of each month what you're up against. And you can simply add, and I can even add that on there because I forgot about the beginning balance. We can put a line item in there that what's the month before ending balance becomes this month's beginning balance. And now you can have a running total. And that's something that's fairly simple to update. And I can do that pretty quickly and I'll update it so that you guys can grab that. What other questions do you have? They've all run off.
Actually, I'm a former tax accountant too, and I've been in for a long time, and I've used Boulevard since 1998. So
yes, I loved. Beauty Advisor. Were you Beauty Advisor beforehand?
Mm-mm.
You went straight to Boulevard. I was the original Beauty Advisor, and then that one moved on, and they converted us over to Boulevard. And that's why I have a hard time letting go because there's 20 years of history. I can't handle moving it to InTouch because it's too much work.
Well, and that's the thing. And you know, like when they came out with my customers, I mean, mm-hmm. there was a purpose in what they did,
absolutely.
But it still doesn't cover all the parameters that Boulevard does, like with covering expenses and all of that. So if I can have it all in one place, but what you showed, what I will say is, and part of the reason I was watching what you showed tonight is invaluable for new consultants who don't have Boulevard. And so like when we're building our teams and we're looking for something easy for them to mm-hmm. learn the principles of all of this, I think that's great.
And that's what I wanted to share, because I think too often it gets too complicated and you're not ready to jump into Boulevard. You're not ready to jump into a software, just like even with QuickBooks. I mean, I have some director friends that use QuickBooks because that's what works for them. But do they need that level? Not as a starting out as a consultant. You do not. And I'm a firm believer to use what's simple because you need to use it. And I think I saw something come in the chat. So hang on a second. Let me jump over there. I actually use for expenses. I am actually in QuickBooks. I converted as far as my expense tracking. I have it using it for QuickBooks. Prior to converting everything to QuickBooks 2 years ago, I used Boulevard because that's where I was going. But now I do all of my, and I connect everything in using QuickBooks this sale. So I use QuickBooks for my finances. When I first started out, though, up until my first couple of years, okay, that's been a long time ago, I used Excel. That's what I did. That's what I used. And I still used Excel, even though I was using the tracking for expenses, I still use it to allocate it out. I used Excel up until I moved into QuickBooks 2 years ago as to allocate that out. So if I had $1,000 in sales for the month, I knew exactly how much I had to work with. And I did that in Excel, because they were formulas and I could tweak my numbers easily enough with the percentages.
So would that be what you would recommend for a new consultant to just use Excel?
Yeah, or Google Sheets in this world. Corporate is Excel. It's just faster for me to create an Excel just because of the formulas and the shortcuts. You know, 25 years of using Excel, but Google Sheets is a great option. It works the same way. And if you're just starting out, take the free version. That's what we started Anna out with, was Google Sheets, because that's what she had.
Is Google Sheets easy to use?
Yeah, it's pretty straightforward. Okay. It is just a spreadsheet. You see the boxes. Let me go ahead and reshare this thing real quick, because it does work exactly the same way. There it is. Zoom moved it around on me. These little boxes that are here, you have different tabs. As I said, this is Excel, so it looks slightly different. I could probably pull up the Google Sheets. But anyhow, as you're looking at it, each box, and you'll notice as you click on here at the top, can you see where I'm kind of circling and I'm kind of highlighting? Mm-hmm. Those are considered formulas, and the formulas is the math. So as we're looking at it, I highlighted in pink here for you to put the number in. And basically, as I change any of these numbers, so if I make that 520, you'll notice that the formulas do the math for me. And it's all based upon these percentages. So if I need to change these percentages and adjust, and I have two extra columns out here, you can actually use that and update it accordingly. But it's pretty straightforward.
So and you're not entering, and in this, if you're doing this, you're not entering each sale individually.
No, because I figured you're doing your weekly accomplishment sheets. Because if they're doing it right and they're sending them to their directors, they're putting it in. So I'm going to assume that that's the direction we're heading. And we're going to take that weekly accomplishment sheet, sales number and the tax number, and drop it in here.
So would that be as sufficient for your income tax records to have a weekly report like this?
Lori, because I always use my weekly accomplishment sheets as support, you know, but I was using Boulevard, so I just run a sales report. Okay. But prior to that, I mean, as far as I'm aware, Laura, you, since you said you were on tax accounting, you maybe answer that even better.
I'm sorry. I had to go check to see if my son shut the garage door. I missed part of what she said.
Oh, question was, as far as the weekly accomplishment sheets, those are sufficient for tax records, correct?
They can be. Well, yeah. I mean, you have to, well, what I do is probably twice what you need to do, just because that's my mentality, is to cover my base. But yes. And Linda could speak to this better than anybody.
Oh, good.
She
Thank
has
you.
An excellent system. But yes, as long as you have your sales receipts to back up what you have on your weekly accomplishment sheet, absolutely.
Okay. Linda, do you have anything to add to that one?
Hi there.
Hey, good to see you. You are. Good to see you.
Yeah, good. I know you don't know this, but I was audited at my job, not for Mary Kay.
Okay.
And so, you know, and I got 100%, so that was good. But I kind of asked him on the side. I had a Mary Kay business, and I said, what would happen if I ever got audited? And he said, well, how do you keep your records? And what I told him is what I do is I take my weekly accomplishment sheet and staple my sales ticket copy to the back of them and put it in an envelope. And I have one envelope for each month, one for income, one for expenses. So, so that weekly accomplishment sheet will work along with the monthly spreadsheet, but you have to have your sales tickets because it has the customer's name, the date of the sale, and the total amount. So that's going to back up what's there. And he said, if I came to your place and you needed to bring me in your records, it would look so much better for you if you took in 12 envelopes for monthly income and 12 envelopes for expenses. Mm-hmm. He said, I would pick out a month and check it, make sure everything added up and check another month for expenses. He goes, then you know what? I would just say you're good because you're organized.
And that's an absolute key. And I appreciate you saying that, because that's what I was told too. They don't even question. The only difference that I do is I get an expandable folder. January, that's the only difference. And I put both expenses and income in that same thing. Yeah. Now, of course, I run my report. So I do everything electronically through Boulevard. Right. So I would just run my report at, you know, I'm now to year end, but they were all right there. And I just drop it in and tie it back to my bank account.
Exactly. Oh, and that's the other thing. Yeah, get a copy of your bank statement and put that in. Correct.
And just drop it in there. And then everything is good to go.
Yeah.
And as you pointed out, that if you're organized, they're not going to question it. But if you go in and take that shoebox in there, which too many people do, and I've been telling this story, you know, I've been talking about Hammy, so I'm on a pig kick right now as we've been doing it. And you can, you know, each pig had their choice. They can do straw, they could do sticks, or they can dig time and really do it out of bricks. And that's their choice. So I kind of equated the straw being like kind of the shoebox. That's that entrepreneur who just says, throw the shoebox there. You know, sticks, okay, great. You have a system that you're working, but you're really not organized. You're really not taking the time to take that one extra little step to be organized and clean and concise. That sticks. And we both know what happened when the big bad wolf came.
Yeah.
And so that's what we want to do, is we want to encourage folks to take the time, be like the pig that built it, so that their brothers come from flying in there and everybody is going to survive, and even be proactive, because what else was built with the guy with the bricks? The little piggy, he put the little boiling pot of water there just so, because he couldn't get in the door. He tried the chimney. That didn't work so well either, because he was prepared. And that's what we want to do.
I wondered if Anna, do you have anything you want to add, or any thoughts on how you do money management at all?
Sure, I would love to. And I would love to say that Janet has been an absolute godsend to me, because I've been in Mary Kay almost 23 years. Next month will be 23 years. And for 20 years, it was pencil and paper, or pen and paper. And so tax time, even though I kept very careful records, I think it was Linda just said about the envelopes, I always did that, but adding up all these receipts took me forever. And I told Janet that was kind of my biggest frustration with tax time, was all the time it took, because I'm not a math person. My background is, I was a preschool teacher when my consultant recruited me. And so I'd never done a spreadsheet in my life. I had no clue how to do it. I'm not a math person. And so she just taught me some really simple stuff. I started using the Google Sheets. And I was like, holy cow, why did nobody tell me this, you know, way before that? And so it has made my life so much simpler. And now I'm actually full-time in Mary Kay. And so it's really helped me even more track my numbers, because now this is how I pay my bills. You know, it's not just a fun side job or part-time job like when I was teaching. So for me, it has been wonderful. And so I would tell somebody who's maybe like me, maybe they're not a math person, or they're not really familiar with spreadsheets, don't let it intimidate you, because it kind of did me at first. And Janet sort of walked me through, showed me how to do just a few simple formulas, and it has made my life so much easier. So thank you, Janet.
Absolutely.
Thanks for sharing, Lori. We have a couple directors on the call. And Linda, did you have anything else you wanted to add about money management, or any thoughts?
The only thing I would say is, it's the daily discipline. So the reason why I even to this day still use envelopes is because when I get a receipt and you're coming in and you have, you know, stuff that you bought or your sales tickets and you're late, and especially for everybody who works another job, you just keep those envelopes on your desk and discipline yourself once a week to go through and put the information on that spreadsheet, on your weekly accomplishment sheet, because it's going to help you in the long run. And then when it's time to do taxes, you're just taking out your month, you know, your month total. So you're not going crazy. It's a weekly discipline to do that.
Okay. So it could be done by pencil and paper if the person wants to avoid.
Even if you put it in the computer, print it out. You know, print it out and put it in the same place. That's why I use envelopes, accordion, whatever.
Yeah.
But the theory is to do it consistently.
Right. And do you have a certain night that you do it, or a day that at time?
Sunday nights. I still do Sunday nights.
Okay.
Monday night. I do mine over the weekend. I aim for Friday, but it's done by Sunday.
Right.
And I've cheated. I use QuickBooks, and now I just scan them right into my phone. So that made it so much easier, which is another reason I switched over to QuickBooks.
What are you scanning?
QuickBooks, the receipts, and I do it as soon as I come
really
to my car.
Really, you scan your receipts right into your phone?
There's so many benefits with QuickBooks on that aspect of it. You know, if you're to that level, I just scan them, drop them in. I do it for my personal, my business, and, you know, either Excel with me or the other one. It just makes my life so much easier because everything's connected then. And then I go straight to that accordion photo and just drop them in. I don't ever look at them again. It's just there for audit because it's that audit brain that I was in the situation of getting too many audits. I was in payroll. So I had like the entourage sitting at my desk, like 5 or 6 of them every single couple of months. It was awful. Yeah. And they would find the one doggone mistake we made every time. But, you know, but I actually had clean audit because I took a lot of time up front. And I'm a firm believer it's worth the time up front. Just as Linda said, it's worth it to do it up front. Schedule yourself that weekly meeting. Take the 5 to 10 minutes. Give yourself an hour if you have to.
Good
and
advice.
You'll find it'll end up being 10 minutes most of the time until you're doing your recon.
Thank you. Now, we didn't hear from Gail. Gail Green, are you still on here?
Yep. Let's see. I have my earphones in. I don't know if you can hear me. Let me.
We can.
I'm not used to using earphones. I'm usually like on speakerphone or something on my desk, but I'm going to walk in here because the ball game's on in here with my husband. but this has been really informative and and this is like, you know, really so perfect of what Mary Kay teaches for the 60-40 split. I am not familiar with Excel very much. It always has kind of intimidated me, but now this intrigues me that I'm like thinking, okay, Excel doesn't look so hard. I think I can do that. So I do most of my things on Boulevard. Mm-hmm. And I do like a file system. And I look at my weekly accomplishment sheets weekly. I do that off of Boulevard and then monthly, I review all of my expenses, you know, income, expenses, is my ratio of what I'm ordering correct? And what is my pay? You know, all of that. I try to look at that monthly because otherwise I could be off and I could spend too much on inventory and then not have enough to pay myself, you know, the amount I want, the 40% or the 30%. So it's really important, I think, to be proactive. I think what you said about being proactive instead of reactive is really so key. And I've always felt strongly about money management. I've never been in debt in my Mary Kay business because I think I've always been proactive. It's just kind of the way my brain works. I was a single mom young in my life and didn't have money. And so I think I've been very careful in my Mary Kay business, mm-hmm. not to get into any kind of debt at all. So if I, you know, if I want to make my star and I have to stretch for that goal, then I make sure I sell it that week. Like, right. You know what I'm saying? I don't let that sit on my credit mm-mm. card. But I think the Excel sheet is so good because it's really going to pinpoint a little bit more accurately exactly where I am. It's going to figure it all out for me. And I don't have to sit down and really do so much pen and paper work.
Right.
But so I really love this. And I think for new consultants, this is such a great presentation of how you did this tonight. So thank you so much.
Oh,
I really think
so
this
welcome.
Is great.
Well, good. Yeah. I'm glad you enjoyed it. And Eileen, your question was, yes, you can download and put your own numbers in. And that's what it's there for, is for you guys to get a starting point.
Okay, well, this is great. Any other questions for Janet? Okay, I hope that you copied that link and you have a copy of what Janet presented tonight. And we will try to get a copy of this video out to everybody. I'm not sure how long we can save it as far as Zoom goes.
Well, it's on my computer, so it's
okay,
ours.
So we can just copy that link and we can share that because I think this is a great presentation.
I'm going to put it up on my YouTube channel. If you go to Excel with Me Training Consulting,
I'm going to
upload it. Yeah, you're going to see a blue diamond. Which is my logo.
And I do
a lot of training. I do weekly trainings and stuff. They're all out there, but I'm going to put a section under Mary Kay as well.
Well, that's
and
good
have
news.
An opportunity. So I'll put this out there and then I'll give you that link and that'll make it even easier.
That sounds perfect. And I'll trying to think of how we can share this with everybody. If you all send me your email, I'm going to stick my email in the chat for you. And trying to think what else. Oh, and I also wanted to tell you a little bit about Janet's book. I'm reading it. I'm not done with it yet, but I love her book. It's more practical information. If somebody, you know, wants to delve into this a little more, I really recommend you get her book. And how can they get your book, Janet?
Just go to janetickes.com and the link's right there.
janetickes.com. Mm-hmm. Okay. So consider that. How much is your book?
On Amazon, it is $17.97.
Okay. So it's a good investment. And I really do believe that one of the biggest reasons women leave Mary Kay is poor money management. I think at some point they start feeling they're not making any money.
Yeah.
And I think when you put it on paper and you look at it, the reason is obvious if they're not making money. It's because they didn't do enough activity. And it sort of, even though they know that, when you put it on paper, it speaks back to you.
And you can't argue thinking, with it.
Yeah. And if you had a $500 week, you could see the big difference between that and a $50 week. Mm-hmm. So it puts the responsibility on us as business people that we need to really look at it as a business. So I thank you so much for this presentation. Welcome. I really enjoyed it. I hope everybody else did.
Thank you. And, I'd love to be able to
thank
do
you.
Stuff.
Let's give her a hand. Yay, Janet. Thank you. All right, everyone, you have a great evening. And wait, here's my email. Let me stick it in there. Okay, it's DZ, Z as in zebra, Mayer, M-A-Y-E-R, 13, at gmail.com.
Well, that explains why it didn't send it to you, Deb. For some reason, I had Deb Z. I do not know why.
My gosh. Okay, now we got that straight.
Now we're straight. And I'm like, wait a minute, that's not what mine said. Mine said, okay. They that'd say be why you didn't get it.
Yeah, that might be why. Well, thank you, Janet. We got that straight. Yeah. Anyway, everyone, if you send me your email, I'll make sure you get copies of this. And again, thank you so much for being on. We
so
appreciate
welcome.
It.
It was nice to see everybody and see the faces. Thank you, Anna, for dropping in as well. Great to see you guys and nice to meet you for those that I didn't know.
Okay, well, thank you all. Bye. Good night.